So well friends, today we are to discuss one of the most important and very critical area of concern on the heading of our discussion of today's class is the means and ways for measuring personality. Means we have placed the title as how to measure personality. Friends, in the last class we discussed about the types of personality and completing our discussion we went back to discuss about the traits of personality. So today we have to know about the means on the measures with the help of which human personality is measured or can be measured. And after completing our discussion on the specific very technical area, we have to discuss about the techniques of measuring personality, which is also very technical. But today in this class simply we have to discuss about the means of measuring personality. And for doing so, friends, we have to understand the term measure so much well, because this term has special importance in the field of psychology. There is a paper which you know about measurement. And the measurement is a term basically which is applied in the field of statistics. And it's a term which we frequently use in our day-to-day life. So friends, just by trying to understand the basic meaning of the term measure, we find that understandably measure means about the process of finding out the size, length or amount of something by comparing it with a standard unit. And for understanding this one, we have to understand statistics. In other terms, measurement means to judge the extent of volume of something. And by saying as how to measure personality means, or we like to mean about knowing about the size of human physiology or the physical aspect, length of human physiological aspect, and the other psychic or mental attributes or capabilities. Means in totality, by considering the physiological parameter as well as the psychic wealth or properties of every human being or individual, we can judge their personality in proper way. Let us see the next slide. Measurement also means about considering carefully what one says or does. So friends, when we use the term measurement in psychology, particularly we use the term to measure personality or in the field of personality measurement, it means or we like to mean about the process of making or passing comments relating to the personality of a concerned person, means his physiological composition, at the same time his or her mental potentialities or composition. Thus, personality measurement very simply means about judging the extent or value of the physical or mental properties of a concerned person. It also means about the judging the extent of well-being, the capabilities and attributes, considering the physical and mental dispositions of a concerned person, which represents his or her physical as well as the psychic capabilities and qualities. On the premise, it is not so much easy to measure psychological potentialities, though to some extent in comparison to the measurement of mental attributes or capabilities. You see, the physiological attributes and capabilities can very easily be measured. Means what I like to say or explain is, to measure the physical attributes in comparison to the measure the mental dispositions or attributes is to some extent easier. Let us go back to the next slide. In the field of psychology, all the psychologists seek to measure personality, that is, the physical or mental capabilities and attributes, through several means and methods, the most common of which are objective test and projective measures. Two types of measures we do get in the field of psychology for measuring personality. And the first category of tests are objective tests, and the second category of tools are projective measures. So by applying or depending on objective tests or projective measures, we can measure personality. What I like to mean is, we can, you see, have estimation relating to the physiological specialities of a concerned person as well as the psychological or mental specialities or special features of a concerned person. Let us see the next slide. There are different personality self-report measures developed by the psychologist. Some of the more widely, extensively used such measures are self-report personality measures are such self-report personality measures are the Myers-Briggs type indicator, the Myers-Briggs type indicator, NEOPI-R MMPI / MMPI-2, 16PF and Arsenic Personality Questionnaire. Means these are the special, you see, most or more widely extensively used self-report personality measures. And these are developed by different experts depending on their research findings. And this is Myers and Briggs type indicator is one such indicator or measure with the help of which we can measure personality, particularly self-report personality can be reported, means measured. And therefore, depending on NEOPI-R, you see, type of self-report personality measure, we can have the estimation of human personality. And therefore, by using MMPI / MMPI-2, you see, we can have the idea relating to varied types or relating to the spatial features of varied people or varied individuals. Therefore, 16PF can also be applied on Arsenic, the name which you have got. Personality questionnaire is also applied for measuring personality, means for knowing about the physiological characteristics as well as mental characteristics of concerned person. Let us go back to the next slide. Let us see. The MBTI, it is the Myers-Briggs. It is very simply known as the MBTI. That is
the Myers Briggs, Isabel Briggs Myers. This is the explanation relating to the details of the concerned psychologist. And Briggs Myers created the MBTI with her mother, Catherine Cook Briggs. These are the explanations. I would like to suggest you to see minutely about these two great psychologists who, depending on their research findings, developed the measuring tools for the measurement of personality. And about them, you please will come to know by knowing about the contents of the slide, which shouldn't be explained much from my side. Type indicator is an introspective self-report questionnaire with the purpose of indicating differing, let us say the next slide, psychological preferences in how people perceive the world around them and make decisions. Means introspective explanations are very carefully considered here in such process of measurement of personality. How we as people introspect ourselves, how I like to define myself, how I like to expose myself before people. You see, these are the estimations of myself. And by understanding or giving sense for introspection, we can, and giving sense to express or place the views concerning to own self or own qualities, psychologists can have the idea relating to the personality of a concerned person. By judging all such decisions, we can measure personality and categorize all such types in understandable manner. The MBTI was basically constructed by Catherine Fu Briggs and her daughter Isabel Briggs Myers for assessing different types of personalities. With the help of the BBTI 16, personality types were created by Isabel Myers and Catherine Briggs to categorize an individual according to categorize, it should be individuals, not an individual, please make the correction. Categorize individuals according to their, because their is their preferred way of thinking and behaving towards different situations of life. Means we try to give the sense to introspect people, and we have to give the sense to evaluate themselves, how they like to, you see, present their views just after facing a particular situation. And by analyzing the views, we can measure the personality of such people. Each personality type is designated with a four-letter code like INFP or ESTJ, which is an acronym for the four key dimensions of personality to determine the types. Let us see the next slide. This way or does the Myers-Briggs type indicator, and in brief, MBTI is an introspective self-report questionnaire with the purpose of indicating the differing psychological preferences in how people perceive the world around them and make decisions as per their individual capabilities. Friends, knowing the world, you see, the process of cognition means how we cognize the universe is a very fascinating, you see, aspect of human individuality. It's a fascinating matter of discussion. Why fascinating?
because we are 100% free to see the world, recognize the world as per our own attributes or capabilities. The world is open. A particular situation, explanation or explanations of a particular phenomenon or event or situation differ from people to people. The ideas we find, differences of opinions and ideas. Why? Because of varied composition of human physiological parameters. At the same time, because of the differences of mental capabilities of varied individuals who are living or existing in this universe. So friends, cognizing the world is a very interesting phenomenon, and it's a very systematic process. And by analyzing and explaining about the way of cognition of different people we meet, we can come to know about the internal capabilities of a concerned person, and we can have the idea relating to the physical chemistry of every person or a particular person of this very dynamic and challenging universe we are living in. So friends, judging personality is a very technical issue, and for doing so, we must have to have extensive knowledge relating to the process of cognition of the world. At the same time, we must have to have the knowledge of psychology, maybe human psychology, maybe social psychology, maybe the psychology of political science, or maybe the psychology of culture, psychology of civilization, psychology of adolescent, psychology of the aged people or the grown-up people. Friends, understanding personality is one of the most important, you see, concerns for assessing people. And depending on the research findings, Myers and Briggs develop the indicator. You see, self means in the form of self-report questionnaire, where the introspective or the introspective issues are being reflected or placed before people for assessing their personality. Means, let us see the next, you see, though the test supposedly is similar to some psychological theories, it is generally classified as pseudoscience, especially as pertains to its supposed predictive abilities. Let's see the next slide. The MBTI is basically based on the conceptual theory proposed by Carl Jung, you have had the name, who had speculated that humans experience the world using four principal psychological functions. How we recognize the universe? As for Carl Jung, the theory of Carl Jung means we have to know about all the theories of learning, how we learn different phenomena of this very challenging universe. And for understanding this, we have to understand human, you see, understand the process of learning. And once we see the concept or the theory which is being provided by Carl Jung relating to human learning, we find that in the process of cognition, you see, four principal psychological functions do have special importance or significance, and these functions are number one, the sensation, number two, the intuition, number three, the feeling, and the thinking. Means sensation, the intuition, the feeling, and the thinking, these are the four most important principal psychological functions with the help of which we can cognize the realities of this very challenging universe. And that one of these four functions is dominant for a person most of the time, and by measuring the nature of domination, we can categorize the personality with total understanding of the inner capabilities as well as the chemistry of his or her physiology. Let us see the next slide. The MBTI was constructed for normal populations and emphasizes the value of necessarily occurring differences. Why differences are here? Why people do not think the same way? Why different opinions we do see? The underlying assumption of the MBTI is that we all have specific preferences in the way we construct our experiences, and these preferences underlie our interests, needs, values, and motivation. And accordingly, we try to represent the picture of realization of this very complex universe. So friends, why opinions differ? If we are to know, we are to understand personality. Why differences are there? Why no consensus we do notice? For understanding all these, we are to understand, you see, personality. Means by understanding personality, we can solve very problem of different aspects of human life and parameters of human society. Let us see the next slide. Although popular in the business sector, the MBTI exhibits significant scientific deficiencies, notably including poor validity. It's a very statistical term. Poor reliability. What is validity? It is being explained here, you will see. Poor reliability. What does reliability mean? It is explained. See. Let us see the next slide. Measuring categories that are not independent. What does it mean? Please see which are being kept under brackets. The four scales used in the MBTI have some correlation with four of the big five personality traits, which are a more commonly accepted framework for the categorization of human personality. Let us see the next slide. If we ask a question as what personality test measure do, the answer of the question basically helps us get the clues concerning to the types of persons living among us in this expansive and complex universe. Among all the means of measuring personality, we find different tests where different tools are used for the evaluation of the types of personality. In the field of measurement, as the tool of measuring, what happens? Let us see. Personality, we find various types of questionnaires about which I discussed in one of the classes of research methodology. As for example, we can mean about the self-report questionnaire where you see the introspective feature or features are reported by a concerned person. A self-report questionnaire where the concerned person is to prepare a report concerning to own self as the answer of the items of the questionnaire is basically used to measure the personality and behavioral style of persons or persons. Friends, we pass comment or comment so much easily relating to the false right deeds and wrong deeds of other people, but it is not so much easy to pass comments on our own self. And for doing so, this most important self-report questionnaire is applied for measuring personality, where a concerned person is to answer all the questionnaires or test items, assessing himself or herself by himself or herself, and the expert will scrutinize the report or the answers of the items, and the expert will assess or make an assessment of the personality of the concerned person. Let us see the next slide. The questions or test items are covered, that is, reading the question or the item does not reveal what it measures and relate to the aspects of the personality of a person which are relevant to the workplace. Covered, you see the meaning. Does means it is explained, items are covered. The days means these days. Thus, different tests, tools and techniques are in use in the field of psychology, and the trend of development of different tests, tools, techniques are continuing, because research on human psychology incessantly has long been continuing, and many new things are coming up, and with the help of thorough understanding, scientific understanding of psychology, the very extensive and complex and mysterious universe or realities of this mysterious, extensive and challenging world can be well realized without any mistake or by committing any mistake. So friends, the issue of understanding as well as measuring personality is one of the most important issues of concern for understanding people and understanding their places in this complex universe amidst buried, you see, unexplored realities. Friends, by understanding psychology, they can understand or have right assertion relating to the realities of different phenomena of this extensive and complex universe. And that's why this is one of the most important issue of concern for every academician or every intellectual, or all academicians, all intellectuals, all researchers. And by understanding psychology so much well, we can understand the problems of human life, human culture, human civilization, and help humanity go ahead without, you see, much mistake for the accomplishment of well-defined goals of life as well as goals of social order, goals of culture, goals of civilization as well. Thank you so much. In the next class, we are to discuss about the techniques of measuring personality, and once we do so, your concepts on or your, you see, ideas relating to the process of measuring personality, I hope will be much clearer. Thank you so much for today.